Today, we're going to deep dive into reporting. There's been some fantastic upgrades and changes to our reporting system over the last few months, and we thought it was a good time, especially coming up to Christmas, to really have a look at the benefits of the system around data validation, and of course, most importantly, your return on investment from the platform by being able to continuously improve both your business processes and of course, your profitability. Jobman can help everywhere. Today, we're going to be deep diving into reporting. I think there is a lot of reporting capability in our platform, and I feel a lot of clients have not yet had the opportunity to really figure out or sort of understand the power behind the metrics in the system and how you can build really customized reporting for your business to make sure that you're getting the data you want all the time, up to date, constantly. That's one of the best benefits of Jobman's system is the way we report is on live data. So as things are changing in your business day to day, every day, seconds of time are being placed against operations, materials are being sourced to purchase order inventory, leads are being generated, created, won, lost, statuses are changing. Our system is continuously updating and pulling that data for you, ready to go, so that you can look at those figures, look at those numbers, and really get the best impact for how you can find improvements, reduce inefficiency, and of course, improve profitability, which is what it's all about. Someone once said to me that reporting or data is the new gold of the modern manufacturing world we work in. And I absolutely believe that having the right data at your fingertips and being able to understand the metrics of everything that's happening in your business is the key to being able to move forward and run a successful business. So today we'll be covering reporting, our new fantastic implementation into the software, which is conditional status filtering, which is very powerful. I'm going to show you a lot of the and/or statements you can use in the software. They're very intuitive. One of the great things about Jobman is whenever we build a feature or a functionality, they're very straightforward to understand and use and benefit from. But I always find it helps just to give a bit of a deeper explanation so that you can find more use cases for your business. So reporting, it's the foundation to all the data-driven management in your business. Without it, there's no knowns. Everything becomes guesswork, estimations, and it's very hard to improve. I've certainly met a lot of businesses in my years who have good or okay processes built into their day-to-day, whether they use, other forms of technology or no technology at all. Business has been around a long time, and data-driven technology is not a new concept in the world we live in, but it is foundational to improvement. You can make any form of guess or change up to your business process, but without knowing what impact that realistically has, all you're doing is a bit of a hope and a prayer to find out. And one of the key things that Jobman really brings to the table early in the implementation process into your business is for most businesses, the really only solid point of understanding they have around their profit loss is end of year. When you go to see the accountant, you break down the year's numbers and, X has come in and Y has gone out, and you can look at those differences and decide where you're at as a business. The downside to that is number one, once a year is certainly not enough to bring a good foundational understanding to where you're at and where things can get better. But most importantly, it doesn't generally provide you the numbers you need to actually improve. It just tells you, we sold more, but we bought more. So things cost more. So we either made less or more money. Really, a lot of Jobman's reporting is around drilling into the key areas that you can tap into to take advantage of to actually make improvement in process. For example, having flexible, live, and accurate data at your fingertips pretty much every day means if things start going wrong in a job, you're aware of it there and then. You may not be able to fix it for that job, but you can certainly improve the process for the next jobs and every job going forward. So it's like a compounding interest of benefit by being able to know that data live today and make those changes today rather than look at it retroactively in 6 months or a year. One of the fantastic new implementation features we've brought to the platform recently is the ability to utilize conditional statuses. So traditionally, most of Jobman's reporting has been very much around the currently in status. So think of it as seeing data where it's at live now, which is the data you want, and that's the data how you can make improvement. But there's also a consideration to be made for seeing where certain processes were up to or statuses were up to as part of that life cycle of the job, and understanding where potentially the mistakes or problems started to happen so that you can then isolate those issues. So being able to use conditional status filtering, and it very much is an and/or statement, which I'll show you briefly in the I'll show you, sorry, in a moment, in the software itself, gives you greater control and flexibility of the management of your reporting. It gives you the ability to real drill down a little bit harder than just generalized statuses or operational control filters. So very exciting, very powerful, and I'm pumped to show you that today. On top of that, we also understand that there is a large number of filters built into our reporting. So one of the key benefits to Jobman is the ability to save custom reports for your business or even your role. So if you have access to reporting, and one of the great things about Jobman is that all of our user permission-based roles are based upon your administrative management of the software. So you can choose who can see what, who can interact with what, even to the point where you can delineate between the different reports for different management heads. For example, if you don't need your project management or job management team seeing your lead reporting, you might cover it once a month or once a quarter with them just so they're across everything that's going on, but it's not part of their day-to-day business and you don't want them to be distracted by that information, you can turn those reports off for them. And then just the CRM management team or the sales management team can be across that side. And similarly, you might not want them having access to stock control reports or other things like that, which are not relevant to their roles. So all of the reporting here is designed so that it can be separated for each of the management heads. And then you can save your own custom reports. And the advantage of the custom reports is it saves those filters, which means you can just go back to that report continuously and the data will refresh live based on the information you've given it. So if you need to run a report every week or a particular report every month, or some reports even are daily, around work in progress and things like that, you can have those saves. You don't need to go and remember those filters. You can just dive straight into the reporting, hit one of your saved reports, and refresh the data and keep moving forward with your day, which is very important. On top of that, all of our reporting in the system is both printable and exportable. We've built some really beautiful formatting into the print capability of the templates for our reports. So that means even from a digital sense, whether you don't have to physically print them, obviously. One of the great things about an ERP like Jobman is we can cut down on your usage of paper. But you can walk into a meeting confidently and bring up a beautifully presented report to talk to the team about the metrics you want to talk to, and they can see it on the screen laid out in a very nice format. It makes it very easy to use and very quick to get across your point around those data analytics. For other companies, you might want to go further with the data that's provided, or you may wish to report across multiple metrics at once and present some information in a particular way. So most of our reports are also exportable to CSV. So then you can take that data, do what you want with it, manipulate it, change it. If you're comfortable with Excel, you can run some scripts and build some quite nice graphical reporting and things like that. But most importantly, it gives our clients the ability to virtually take any data set out of our system and then utilize it in the way they want to see it. So it's a very, very flexible system and allows for a lot of customization and comparisons on top of the standardized reporting that we include. Something that's worth mentioning early on is in no way, shape, or form is our reporting set finished. One of the great things about Jobman is we continuously having new clients and businesses come on board. People's really seeing the benefit of this platform for manufacturing, especially at the price to value point of market we sit. And we're constantly getting requests around new features, new improvements, ways that we can expand on the reporting to give our clients even more data at their fingertips. So if you are coming to this now and you've been utilizing our reporting and you're thinking to yourself, there's other areas that we'd love to be able to report on or see, Absolutely. We're always taking that feedback on board. And as new features come out, we're finding new and interesting ways to then bring that into the reporting. For example, for many of you who follow this webinar series, you'd be across the fact that recently we developed and released critical operation dates. Absolutely fantastic addition to the software, solves some really big problems for a lot of businesses, provides a lot of transparency. One of the things the team has confirmed already is that our intention is to bring those critical operation dates into our lead and job reports. So it's just another way where we bring new data sets into the software to improve the functionality of your business. We also then look to help bring that back into the reporting. So never feel in any way, shape, or form that our platform is a static platform. We don't just produce to market, release it, and run off and do something else. Jobman is always getting better, which is very exciting from a return on investment point of view. Part of that consideration is I'm extremely pleased to announce a recent massive works project completion with an integration partner, SKJ Consulting. SKJ Consulting has a lot of experience in the manufacturing sector and has been serving Australian businesses for a long time. And one of the great thing about them as from a partnership point of view is they have a very deep understanding of engagement requirements for clients in the manufacturing space. And one of the things they've been able to do and put together is an incredible platform utilizing our API, which connects to their Microsoft Power BI services they provide, which gives absolutely insane, and I mean that truthfully, insane customization of dashboards and live data reporting. So this is a phenomenal new development. It really allows clients who love Jobman, utilize Jobman, and get a lot of benefit from its business. If you want to take that next step with your reporting and create really custom, dashboards and metrics, very specific and tailored to your business, I absolutely recommend you reach out to SKJ. They're on our website. You'll find them on jobman.com under implementation partners and supplier partners. And they have provided an amazing solution here for clients. This is just a snapshot they sent through a recent video of a design they've built for a company. And you can see that they've broken all the information down into live data. So it's not just dashboarding, it's also the ability to manipulate and control the data outside of Jobman and really get the best out of your software. And ultimately, the ERP is there to provide the metrics, and via our API, they are able to pull out some incredible amounts of data. So a bit of a plug there, but I absolutely wanted to throw that in because I think this is an amazing opportunity, especially if you're a medium to large scale business. You would understand the absolute importance of having metrics, and certainly being able to see dashboard metrics the way you need to see them is very important. And that's one of the powers of Jobman being built on an open API. It means companies can reach out and develop these third-party integrations, which you then as a client can take advantage of without having to necessarily, wait for us to develop something or, try and push some custom development run. These companies are seeing these problems and they want to help solve them for the industry and are able to use our API and build some incredible technology. So absolutely worth reaching out and having a chat to them if this is something of interest to you. So without further ado, let's jump in and let's have a chat about some of these reporting and the new certainly definitely the custom filtration of statuses. I'm in a bit of a different site today. I'm in one of our mainstay demonstration sites. Reason being is I wanted a site with a lot of data in it so that I could really show you this reporting filtration at a pretty good level so that you could get a good understanding of its use cases. But keep in mind, the beauty of Jobman is it's been designed as almost like an open world. It's there for you to be able to go and operate the system how you want to run it, and then take the data and put it in such a way that makes most sense for your business. So we'll start because our main focus today is on conditional summary reporting. I actually want to start with one of our most popular reports, which is our quote summary report. This report has phenomenal impacts for businesses straight off the bat. Aside from being able to produce this report direct from individual quotes, which creates a phenomenal level of data validation before you've even sent a quote out to the client. You know, what are my total operational hours? What are my material breakdowns? And what are my service expectations coming from this quote wrapped up into a nice format so I can see that information live and easily? I can know these things before the quote even goes out the door, which is fantastic. So basically, you know, not only is Jobman, you know, profit-driven quoting, we also give you the ability to validate that data and ensure that the correct decisions and right allowances are being made before it's even gone out the door. And that in itself is a huge problem solver for a lot of businesses. So many businesses, you know, when they're running their quotes, it's a bit of a hope and guess. We're hoping we've allowed for enough materials and time in this quote to win the job. And I hear it almost every day, people saying, you know, in their old systems, there was no way of validating that, which means quite often they would run a job and partway through the job, they realize almost immediately there weren't enough allowances. So Jobman really helps solve that problem straight off the bat and puts money back in your pocket. Part of that quote summary reporting, though, is we've introduced the new conditional status formatting, which means you can also utilize this report from a sales management point of view. So you can look at this report and really start to drill down into quotes based on their statuses, where they've been, where they're going. And you can see the vast number of metrics we provide, even just in a quote like this, from material breakdown to service costs, labor costs, net profit. On each of those areas divided and broken down, you can see discounts, appliances, sorry, discounts applied, overhead and wastage comparisons, all at the touch of a button. And you know, I think this is a good moment. I'll just quickly bring up the print scalability report. Now, I have not filtered this report in any way, shape, or form. So this is a open world report at the moment. This is like a life cycle metric of a lot of the demonstrations we've put through the software. So you can see the vast amount of data that it's pulling together. And it will only take a few moments to grab that data and produce. In fact, it's spending more time at the moment producing the PDF than it is validating that. You can see the data came up almost immediately, 29.8, whatever it is, almost $30 million worth of quoting. And we're able to pull that report together extremely quickly. So the fantastic thing about the Jobman breakdown system is because all of this information here is live, we can find that information quickly and deliver it to you, which is what it's all about. We're not trying to go look for filtered information and break it down and return it. We can actually grab that information extremely quickly. And you can see here, this is 34 pages of report in just a matter of moments. And what I love about the way they've built the print in is even if you don't want to physically print it, all the data in across a lot of the reports is shown in a really nice, clean digital format. So like I said, you can bring this up in a meeting, you can see your key metrics above based on the filtration that you've provided, and then really start to dive down on particular lines and break that information apart, which is awesome. Not just that, like I said, the CSV reporting, so you can pull it apart even further. But what we really want to look at today is the filtration capability of the system. The ability to say, hey, I can see my total data, but now I need to drill down and really start understanding some key areas. Which brings me to my first point about Jobman's filtration system. Jobman's filtration is designed around bringing the report information based on the filters you want to see and filtering the total number of reports into that data set. What it doesn't do, what it's not designed to do, is filter the data. Because to us, that doesn't make a lot of sense. You know what I mean? What you're trying to do is you're trying to limit the view so you can filter and hone in on the data you want to see. What we're not trying to do is manipulate the data to see it in, say, for a time period. What we're showing you is the data set within that time period, not the data modified itself. Because that's the important part. Most reporting is of little consequence post hoc. You know what I mean? Realistically, what you're trying to find is the numbers today to make the improvement for tomorrow. So that's the first thing to note about our system is that all of the date ranges in here are designed around eliminating the data. So we're trying to bring you focus the report. So we give you a filtered set of data, sorry, filtered set of responses rather than filtering the data. So I hope that makes sense. If you have any questions around that, do ask at the end. It took me a moment to get my head around, but it certainly does make a lot of sense when you're using the system. So you'll notice that with our reporting, most of the filters are broken into what we call key areas or headings so that they make a bit of sense. And generally speaking, most of these are or statements. So what I mean by that is if I am limiting data, I'm limiting it to make sense within the parameters I give it. So for example, if I was to type in a quote number here and I want to see just that quote, I can do that. If I enter a quote number and then I use a status filtration or a contact, and that status filtration or contact doesn't make sense for that quote number, it's not going to show any data because it's an or statement. It's like you've told the system you want to see this, but then you've told it to find things that aren't relevant to that thing. So that's just an important thing to keep in mind. The great thing about Jobman is it's very quick to filter that data. So even if your filtration doesn't work the first time, it's pretty easy to make some quick modifications and then find the data. What we generally advise is go wide first and then come in. So rather than, unless you have a particular need to look for a particular quote, for example, or something set in a custom date range or a custom expiry range, is really utilize this status filtration because it will help you find the data you're looking for much quicker. So what is conditional status filtration? Essentially, statuses, for those of you who are aware of Jobman, or if you've seen this for the first time on the YouTube and you're in the consideration process for what Jobman can do for your business, everything in Jobman is designed around the automation of status. Status is the ability for our system to tell you where things are up to in simple terms. You know what I mean? A quote has a status, much like an invoice has a status. Status one might be created. I've created the quote, so it's sitting in that status. So if I want to filter my reporting and see all my quotes that are sitting in the created status, I can do that. The automation of Jobman is when you send that status, when you send that quote or invoice to the client or your accounting software, we can then update the status automatically into quote sent. So that's the new status. And similarly, once it becomes quote accepted, that's the new status. So the beauty of statuses in the software is one, high level visibility. They let you know where everything is up to, from jobs to leads to quotes to invoices to purchase orders. You know, all of that is being controlled and managed by statuses. Number two, they're automated. As processes change in your business, you're not the one having to go into our software and update all these things. The software does it for you. But thirdly, and probably the key, is that they are the ability then to filter information quickly to see what you want to see in a real world sense. So traditionally, all of our reporting was built in what's called the currently in status. If I filter to quote sent or estimate sent, what I'm telling Jobman is just show me all the quotes right now that are sitting in the sent status that have not yet been accepted or declined. So it's a good report, for example, for your sales team to be able to follow up on. Show me all the numbers of quotes that we have come in that are currently sitting in those statuses that are ready to go out. You can see almost immediately it returns. Okay, so currently I've got two quotes outstanding that have not yet been accepted. This is a great opportunity to follow up on these clients and put some more dollars on the door. Easy, very straightforward. And the beauty, as I said, is you can save any particular custom filtration you do as a custom report. So if you have a couple of key metrics with your reporting that you need to follow up on each week, let's say we'll just use the sales management team as an example here because we're in quote summary reporting. But if you need to see each week, you want to run a report on, hey, show me all the quotes that have been accepted. So I've got a good value idea of how much we've brought through the door. Show me all the quotes that have been declined. So I've got the ability to see how many quotes we're losing comparatively speaking compared to the amount we're winning. And or show me all the quotes that are sitting in a sent status or created status. So they're quotes that we've made, we've spent the time on and resources been put towards, but have not yet harbored business going forward. You might save those three reports as custom reports, and then each week you can just come in and go directly to that custom report and run it, and it'll update that data based on your current filters. So that's the first thing to note. Very easy, very important. You can call it whatever you like as well. So you can name them as you would want to see that information. So that all makes sense, and that's fantastic. Most people are pretty comfortable with the way this information revolves in our filtration systems. However, the power of conditional statusing is to say there are times in which I also need to understand the data in a historic sense or at a moment in time sense. So for example, we have four filters in this particular report. There are different filters, slightly different filters to other reports, which I'll show you in a second. But for the quote summary reporting, we have the four most relevant conditional status reporting. So currently in makes sense. It's in there right now. Show me everything right now that we're looking at. was in is the ability to see a status that was retroactively in that period. So, for example, it's November, I walk into my sales meeting and I want to show all of the quotes that were in the sent status in October. So, was in the status of quote, let's say quote sent, again, quote sent, we'll keep the data the same during the period of this quarter, this financial year, last week, last month. So I'm running this report in November because I want to know. So the important thing to note here is that we're not delimiting the data. What we're filtering is the results. So we're saying, show me all of the quotes that were in that status during that period. So if I was to go into a meeting and put those two numbers side by side, I could say, here's report one. Here's all the quotes we sent out in October. And now it's November. Now let me show you all of the quotes currently in, quote accepted. So we can say, you know, we quoted $500,000 or $1 million worth of work last month, and we actually won $800,000 of it. Go team. Or we put out $1 million worth of quotes last month, but we only won 200,000. Potentially, there's an issue with our follow-up process. That's a lot of money outstanding that we could be bringing into the business. So that's how you can really utilize this conditional status reporting to get really important key metrics for comparison in your business. And it's not just was in, we also have entered and exited. And the difference here, sorry, I'm just going to refer to my notes quickly just so I make sure my language is very correct for you. Entered is the ability to say, and we'll use our estimate sent quote sent ability example here. This is to say that the quote entered the status of being sent during that period. Now, the difference you might be asking is, you know, what's the difference between was in and entered? It comes down to timing. So, for example, was in looking at last month is looking at the status of the quote being in it for any period of time. It could be a day, it could be a week, it could be an hour, it could be a month. So long as it was in the status of quote sent last month, we'll bring you back that data. Entered could be that you sent out a quote on the 20th of October. So it entered the status of quote sent. However, the client doesn't come back to you till November to actually accept. So it's seeing that period of time to say how many of our quotes went in to that status. And similarly, exited is the reverse. So exit is the fast way of being able to say, what I really actually want to know is how many of those quotes were accepted or declined. So show me how many of them exited the quote status of quote sent. Because I want to know how many we won or how many we lost. And that's how you can start to really quickly develop some key metrics around the system and start to bring apart that reporting and refine further and further and further until you get the information you really want to see. And again, by saving these custom reports, you'll be able to access that data really quickly. So I hope that makes a bit of sense. I'm gonna show you other conditional status reporting filtration in the system because it might help explain that a bit better. I just like to start with the quote one simply because it gives the fast ability to see the information quickly and sort of it makes a lot of sense for people like, oh yeah, quote sent versus quote accepted versus quote created. Those are three straightforward statuses. I sort of get it. When we start talking about manufacturing lead process, it gets a little bit more complicated, but the process in principle is the same. So you can see here, I had a filtered report already in the system built, and I was looking for target due dates built and entered for the last financial year. So I was very quickly able to break down my job cost reporting into 14 jobs that meet these requirements. Now, it's a very strange requirement set, and I've done it intentionally just to show you the power of the filtration of this system. So again, most of the generic reporting headers make a lot of sense. Do I just want to quickly look for a job number? Just give me my breakdowns on that job number. I want to know, have a quick meeting, find me that information. Or do I want to see all the costings around my job types, particular builder, maybe versus commercial versus residential versus, you know, private versus mining, however you have defined and called your contact types and job types. Again, fantastic use of a lot of the things you build in our software. Don't just have benefit to the automation of your workflow process. They're also designed then to improve your reporting, give you that real capability. I mean, I don't like telling stories, but recently we had a client that I've been doing a bit of work with, and they were running reports on the last year of using Jobman, and they were discussing marketing budgets. And they were thinking to themselves, how can we utilize our reporting from all this data we've trapped to improve that process? And one of the things they did was they looked through their contact types and job types and ran a comparison report between the profit loss job costing on each of those different areas. And then they married that number up to the amount of money spent looking for that particular type of work. Obviously, referrals a bit different. But for example, they were putting a lot of money into a local magazine to try and attract more private residential work. And it was costing them about 14 grand a year. They looked at their private residential numbers, and their private residential numbers year on year hadn't moved. They, in fact, hadn't gained any more business. They were getting the same amount of just normal referral private business, and whatever they were spending on this magazine was not having a large enough impact. In fact, I think they worked out based on their job types that it actually brought one sourced contact, one client, 10 grand job. So that told them immediately that isn't worth the money. So they were able to remove that budget, 14 and a half grand, from their marketing business, and then decide where to put it into other job type areas that were growing for them and more profitable. That one decision just put $4,500 back in their pocket. That's the power of the reporting here. So don't be afraid of the, or I should say, don't be worried about what you see from the filtration sets. Once you get into them, they're very, very, very powerful. And we can even break that further down into items. Yet another use case for the item breakdowns. And you see these a lot in the quoting and the item specs, and people are often wondering where all of that leads. Hey, we don't just break down information for you based on, builder versus private versus manufacturer. You can even go even further to say, based on my items, whether it be kitchen or bathroom or fencing or, power conductors or machine, whatever it is you manufacture, being able to even break that down even further, compare my, my manufacture work versus my service work versus my bespoke work, all at your fingertips. But again, here you can see the power of this concentration, concentrated custom filtration. So the ability to say, I want to see a job cost report based on all of the jobs that entered my first status in this particular instance, which is pre-production. That's like our job setup status this financial year. So this is quite a large data set, but it's what I want to look at. I want to look at all the work we've done this year so I can run a high level number of estimates versus actuals and start to get some processed information. I can then utilize further filtration, utilizing the operation status to say, actually, what I really want to focus on is the jobs that met and entered or finished install and setup where the target due date was in that year. And the reason I might want to do that is because if I just run the first system, what it's going to tell me is going to tell me all the jobs that entered pre-production in that year. But what if a job starts, let's say, in December? I really haven't started working on it yet. And it's not going to enter installation into Jan, Feb, which means I'm realistically not going to get paid for it potentially to February, realistically. So I don't really want to factor that into my job cost numbers because I want to understand right now what this year has looked like as a whole. So this is where you can utilize the operational statuses to really, sorry, the operational filtration to really hone that information. And the beauty of this is it's multi-select. Both these filters are multi-select, so I can filter this information down to a number of statuses to really give the best information that I'm looking for. So this is really powerful. And the beauty of this is, again, it is very much, and or. So I don't need to operate these filters. I can start wide, as I said, and start to have a look at the information and then go, oh, actually, I've got a problem there. I don't want to see all the installs that are happening next year just because we've kicked the job off this year. It's not relevant to my reporting because it's not going to seek the money in the bank. Therefore, I just want to drill that down a little bit. I'm going to apply the filter at a more looser sense, and then I can start to drill down, which is awesome. And again, we have the opportunity here to see currently in. So everything that's currently in, for example, the status of installation or dispatch, the key status in your business, the critical status for which the job is done, and we're going to get paid. So just show me everything we're currently in there so I can run my costings on that and I know what I'm doing right now. Or again, I can use the was in to make those comparison points, entered and exited to see that. But you can see if I modify those details there, I can get a really good wider understanding. We don't just leave it there, though. We also have the ability to drill down specifically into contacts. So one of the great things about Jobman is quite often when people are utilizing our CRM services, is they really what they're trying to do is they're trying to build a way in which they can report really cleanly on different types of work. So let's say, for example, 40% of your business is account-based. That might be commercial, might be continuous work over and over. It might be contracts, it might be government, whatever is relevant to your manufacturing business. So you might then want to be able to just isolate this information directly to the contact. For example, we'll just throw it out there. So let's say BHP Mining. You might do some work with BHP Mining and you have a continual manufacturing process set up with them. So you want to be able to run those numbers and see that information directly for them. You can just break it down on that contact. You can also utilize member types and members to really break that information down even further. So you might want to know all of the jobs that we've run this year that have the operation install, where the operation team or installer is specifically this person. That's how granular you can get with our system. It's incredible the amount you can use these filters. Often people see these filters and they think, oh, you know, it's a bit basic, bit generic. When you start to understand what you can do with this filtration system, it's absolutely incredible. Now, I'm just going to make quick special note of this particular functionality here because it's a bit different to all the other reporting and probably doesn't make a lot of sense directly off the bat. As many of you are aware, one of the great powers of Jobman for improving business process is we don't just handle and tackle job management from an automation point of view. We also give you the ability to break down jobs into what we call work orders. So you can take larger jobs and separate them down into work orders. And one of the benefits to businesses around that is as part of producing and creating those work orders, we also take with the work order the relevant time, materials, services, etc. So there's a really nice automation process of, hey, I've quoted, I've broken it down into my different items. We'll just use kitchen, bathroom, laundry as an example because it's just easy to get your head around and just say, hey, I've separated the kitchen into a work order, the bathroom into a work order, laundry into a work order. And there are now three independent jobs in my system, still linked and married to the parent job, say job 100.1, 0.2, 0.3. The benefit of which now is my times have come across, so my automated scheduling still works. I've pulled my material resources into each of them individually, so my estimate versus actual for my purchase ordering and inventory sourcing works. My services have come through. All of that benefit is there. The trick then is people say, hey, I want to be able to break that information down so I can run my comparisons so that I know inside this job, let's call it job 100, I know the exact profitability and breakdown of this part versus this part versus this part. So I'm not just looking at the job as a whole and finding those metrics. I can also go in and say, actually, the kitchen laundry were fine, but we had some issues where we damaged some material and we had to purchase order above and beyond 15% of our material expectation costs. So it wasn't that our whole job wasn't profitable. It was the fact that the bathroom mistakes and issues cost us profitability across the job. And I can drill into that and see that just in that work order, which is fantastic because then you can look at that information and make those changes to improve and ensure if it doesn't happen again or it can't be stopped. There's some things in the world obviously can't be stopped. Mistakes always happen. But if we can improve processes to mitigate or reduce the amount of wastage and error handling in our system, the better our business. So that's fantastic. Jobman can handle that. But then the most common question we get is, sometimes, though, you just want to sit back a step and just go, actually, I just want to see the numbers for the whole job. So this particular little super button right here, what that will do is it will just wrap. It doesn't actually hide them. It just wraps all the numbers of the work orders independently into the parent job so that you're just looking at one total of fixed amount. So just wanted to let you know what that one was for. It's a common question we get on the support line, so I thought I'd throw this in the webinar. But you can see just like that, immediately I can loosen up my filtration and within seconds, Jobman returns the data relevant to all of my information. It will highlight directly and immediately areas that are going wrong. You can see that I've intentionally blown up some numbers here, just to really show you the power of the software and what can happen when things start to go wrong. So it's highlighted and it's very direct and informational. And one of the other benefits of the job cost report over other reports in our system is it's also capable of being drilled into. So I can dive in here and I can go another step further and I can start to break down the actual operational times, actual operation adjustments, material categories, sections and services based specifically just on that job. So that's one of the powers of the job cost reporting is you can go in and you can see times allocated. And what I wanted to show you quickly was there's another benefit to this drill down in that a lot of our reporting in the system is linked. So much like the quote report where you create a quote, you can hit a button and create the quote summary, there are areas in our software where we link relevant reports so that you can drill down and find specific information without being torn away from your reporting. And this is a great example. So inside this fantastic report here that I've drilled down, I can really see my operational allowances and differences based on the job as it's happening right now. What are the, or if it's closed and finished, where we're up to where we were at. I can see my breakdowns of that information, and immediately I notice that there was an issue in the job setup. We have an expectation that it was only going to take about half an hour, and it took 2.5 hours. First question you're going to ask is why and who? So the great thing about Jobman is I can click directly onto that actual time spent, and what we'll do is we'll immediately change and bring up an effort report based specifically on those expectations. You can see here, the estimator was 30, took 2.5 hours, Aaron. Okay, I'll just go have a quick chat to him. You know what I mean? Just to have a chat to Aaron, find out what happened on that job. That's quite an incursion into our profit loss consideration. Is there a process that we need to improve? Are we not allowing enough in our estimations for this particular operation? Or was it just a random case? You know, was it just a random offset, an outlier to our data, so to speak, that we just weren't anticipating? So this is fantastic. And you can see here, it's opened up a new tab so I can just come back directly to where I was to find that information and break it down. And if I had multiple staff persons here, I could even see each of their time and operational allowance built into that effort, which is fantastic. I mean, ultimately, that's what you're looking for, is the ability to not just break down this data, but see this data in a realistic sense to give you the most information possible for you to make those validations going forward. So there is a lot of reporting built into our system. Obviously, the primary reports look very standardized, but as I said, as you start to go into them and you start to understand filtration and see the ability to break down these areas based on time, based on staff, really having a look at total times and allowances built into operational areas, you can even break most of these further by specific operations, specific types of work that you're doing, total hours, configurations, you know, breakdowns, what they were working on. The amount of information Jobman can provide to you is extremely impressive. There is a lot of data being trapped every moment of every day. I'm just going to quickly bring this up because there's a question I get often. Why do we have a filter restoration every time I go into a new quote? A new report. Now, the truth is most people, once they start using our system properly, will actually build a number of custom reports, and they would not be doing what I'm doing right now, bouncing in and out of report centers. They'd have their custom reports. They go straight to the custom report here, run the report, ready to go. However, one of the things we wanted to make sure is that if you were in a management meeting, for example, and you started to break down information, you're running filters and you're modifying reports to really isolate the information you want to see to tackle a particular problem in your business, there's nothing worse than the idea that you might spend, you know, 20 minutes putting all those together, find the perfect report, forget to hit save custom, and then you leave the page and come back and it's gone. So that's what this essentially is. It's the ability to say, hey, based on your last session, do you want to see the filters that you had in? In this instance, I just had a filter report showing all my stock considerations for handles at the moment, in which case it'll just take you back there. If you don't, just hit discard, not a problem. But as I said, most of the time, you would be saving these as custom reports so that you can go back to that information constantly in one click without having to go through the filtration process. Really, the filtration process is just around the first time. You know what I mean? I want to see all the handles currently linked up with Hayfleet, for example, based on a particular brand. And again, inside our system, we have a lot of conditional ability to really refine that information even further, such as, you know, show me all of the stock where it is greater than this number or more probably specifically in this particular instance for this report, less than this number. So if you want to run fast reporting on your common items that you want to keep stock of, you can save a custom report, which is just basically show me all my hinges, all my boards, and my particular drawer kits that I keep in stock. Run those three reports, have them sitting there, and just run them so that every week when you need to do a purchase order, it takes you 2 seconds to be able to pull up the numbers you need to see if you want to add some more stock into your system. And again, the beauty of this report is that it is all designed around live metric information. So it's how much are we sitting on today? We know exactly the numbers. We can see what's been assigned to jobs, what's been broken down. We have filtration to remove that, by the way, so that you can separate into to stock and unassigned. That's what this little magic filter down does down here. Assignment, so the assignment is assigned to jobs and not assigned for stock. And then we also have the ability to exclude removed items. Again, that's one of those magic little filters where it says, hey, this process has gone through our business, it's gone into our inventory, it's been purchase ordered, come into our inventory, used for the jobs, it's out the door. I don't care about it from my stock numbers point of view. It's irrelevant now. It's done. So a lot of fantastic ability there to really improve your filtration, even for what most people consider fairly simplistic reporting in a stock report. Again, a lot of power to be able to come back in and benefit your business. Purchasing reports. This is really best described as a purchase item report. So this is the ability to see items, purchase order statuses, where things were up to. Again, we have the ability to break that down by supplier, brand, particular status. Just show me everything at the moment that's in the partial receive status. You know, quick and easy, quick numbers. That's what I really love about Jobman is the ability to find the information you want to find really fast. Show me all, you know, it's coming up to Christmas. Show me all of the purchase orders that are pending that have not yet arrived or are in the partially received or ordered status. So I have an idea of how much stock we're still waiting for to come in before Christmas. So I can know when I need to start telling my suppliers to get a wriggle on because we'll be closing up on the 16th, for example. So a lot of power and functionality there. Again, the ability to show me purchase orders where I ordered units greater than 100 with a particular supplier so that if I'm having a conversation with my suppliers around numbers, metrics, pricing, you know, account pricing, I can show them, hey, in last year we bought, you know, 2,500 of this particular item with your business. And we've kept that with you out of loyalty. But we've also been approached by two or three other companies who offer the same product or a similar product, and they're offering some pretty good pricing. What can you do? And you can run the numbers and show it to them right in front of them based on, you know, the supplier, the type, the breakdown, the category, all of that information at your fingertips, easily printable, easily exportable, and most importantly, easily customized, filtered, and then saved so that you can just keep coming to these jobs and these reports all the time. You know, just break them down quickly, find the information, move on with your day. Have your meetings, get the metrics, make the improvement, all at your fingertips, which is super exciting. And really I would hesitate to guess. I mean, you know, I spend a lot of time in these webinars really discussing user case functionality for a lot of benefits of the platform in business around improvement of flow. But the ultimate truth is all of that data and all of that use case and automation that we're providing your business is the first layer of return on investment. The big return to any company is being able to then see that information, see the net result, and most importantly, then test and re-see. It's all about continuous level of improvement, not just the you know, I made a change and I don't know what happened. Maybe it was a good thing, maybe it wasn't. You know what I mean? Very common that our platform is actually recommended by consultants, business coaches, you know, teams outside within our sphere of ecosystem of manufacturing in the digital or non-digital space who go into businesses and really help them improve process and remove and mitigate some wastage and inefficiencies and get some good return on investment and value within their business. And so many times it's actually the business coaches that will then recommend to the clients, you now need to go get a tool. You need to go find a platform, and Jobman is a particularly good one, especially in the bespoke manufacturing space, that will then give you the metrics to see the improvements we're making. It's like a validation within a validation, and it happens almost every day. Someone comes along and they go, look, I've just started this process of improvement. I'm looking for a platform. I've been told yours will certainly help. And, you know, working together, we can help validate the improvement process in your business and then give you the numbers to back that up. And for a lot of companies, even if it's not their primary thought process behind coming to something like Jobman, your top of mind constraint or concern might be capacity or work management or faster quoting or inventory control or kiosk validation or all these things that the platform provides. Ultimately, in the back of your mind, that's what you really want to know. You want the data to come out the other end and give you the visibility that you're looking for, so that things become known. And I think the greatest thing about business is that when things become known, you know you're making the right decisions. And most importantly, you know where you can improve on those decisions. And it just takes a lot of the stress off the shoulders of business owners to actually know. It also improves massively. One of the side benefits to Jobman's reporting I've certainly seen in businesses is the ability then to really bring the team into this process. Quite often you see, I see it all the time. I don't know if anyone sort of watches or listens to podcasts from digital transformation experts. And one of the jokes they love to make constantly is, oh yeah, we're implementing this new system and the team's resistant, not behind it because of blah, blah, blah. We don't get a lot of that with Jobman. We get the reverse. A lot of people say to us very soon after implementing the platform that one of the great benefits of the system is not just bringing people into the system and getting them to use it, and they enjoy it because for the first time potentially in ever in your business, they have the ability to have knowns around what they need to do next. They know where they're heading. They know what time frames needed. They can see critical dates. They understand. It's like they're being brought along for the mission of your business, and they feel in control, so that they know they have the control and power then to improve and benefit the workplace. They can bring value. Better than that is the system then can provide you the metrics to back that statement up. We've had it so many times where Jobman has come into a business and they've implemented it for the product management team, and it's not until it's actually brought down to the staff level and the staff start using it that the implementation really takes off and the data starts coming through and people start loving it because they feel in control. But also when they're talking to you in your role as business owner or project manager, they have the conscience of power to know that you have the metrics defined relative to them. They know that you know how hard they're working. They can show it. They can prove it. They can say, hey, I produce jobs 10% faster in my operational area than everyone else on the team, and I make less mistakes. You know what I mean? And that is a phenomenal experience of empowerment, but also bringing people together in a team to keep things moving forward in a right direction and knowing that the metrics are there. And for a lot of companies, those metrics don't exist, and people can sort of feel a little bit underappreciated or undervalued because they actually physically don't have a way of measuring their value for your company. And now every member of the team really does. And that's absolutely exciting. And whilst I love and find those TikTok quite humorous, I think that the bigger benefit here is not just the ability to improve process in business, but to really bring the team on board and help your whole business and everyone in it become an absolute success.